Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, I will quickly show you how to build, test, and deploy your React Native Expo application to the App Store. I am an Android user, so I will deploy my apps to the Google Play Store. I published the app in the Google Play Store, and you can see it on the screen. Just follow the video, and don't skip anything, otherwise you will miss something. First, let's start an Expo application. Select the blank template and continue to download dependencies. Here, I am going to make a very simple application, so it won't take much time. If you are in a hurry, you can skip a few minutes, but I suggest you watch the video. For this application, I am going to add a title, image and description. Now, add some styles to the title, image, and description. Next, run the application. Oh, I missed adding the image to the assets folder. So, I am going to add the image and rerun the application. Now, you can see that our application is running absolutely fine in the Expo Go app, as expected. Now, we are going to build an APK for this Expo project. For this, we are going to follow the official documentation. Step 1 is to install the EAS-CLI in our project. Step 2 is to log into our Expo account. If you don't have one, create your Expo account, and then log in with the same credentials here. Step 3 is to configure our application for the build. Here, I am going to test the APK on my Android device, so I will select Android here. Now, our application is well configured, so let's build an APK. Use the following command in the terminal window to build an APK. I will not suggest you make changes to the Android application ID if you're building an APK for the first time. It's a one-time change thing, so be aware if you change it. Next, we will let Expo generate a new keystore. If you are using Android Studio, then you can add your custom keystore here too if you want. Now, our application build has started, and you have to wait for some time. It may take 5 to 10 minutes to complete the build. In the meantime, don't forget to read the documentation. Like, if you are using a private NPM package, then you have to add the NPM token. Does your app code depend on environment variables? Add them to your build configuration. There is more to read here, so read this information if you are working on a big project. Now our build is complete. Download this build from the official Expo website. After downloading, I am adding this APK to my Android device and then installing this APK. After the installation, you can see that the response time of the application is fast and it's smooth. Here, I missed something to add, the app icon and adaptive icon. I already made the image with the exact pixel it requires and then replaced it with the original one. But unfortunately, we can't see the changes in this APK because we already built it. Now, let's build our app for production. Use the command EAS build and select Android. Now, wait for the build to complete. Last time, we built the APK. But this time we are building an AB file. AB stands for Android App Bundle. We will add this AB file to the Google Play Store. Our AB build is complete. Download the AB from the Expo website. Now we are going to push this app to production. You need to have a Google Play console account to publish your app on Google Play. If you don't have one, you can create it by visiting the Google Play console website. Keep in mind that there is a one-time registration fee of $25 to publish your application. Once you log into your dashboard, you can start creating your app by clicking on the Create App button. Here, you need to provide some basic details about your application, such as its name, whether it's a game or an app, and whether it's free or paid. Make sure to read everything carefully before filling out the form. In the Set Up Your App section of the dashboard, you will need to fill out some important tasks. The first task is to provide a privacy policy URL. If you don't have one, you can create a simple static HTML page for your policy and host it using GitHub Pages. If you need help with this step, let me know in the comment section, and I will create a quick video to guide you through the process. Once you have a URL, add it to the Privacy Policy section of the dashboard and save it. Next, you will need to manage any restricted sections of your app, such as memberships, subscriptions, or any other restrictions. This is important because if Google reviewers can't review your app, they might block it from being published. If your app contains ads, make sure to select Yes in the App Access section. When it comes to content rating, you will need to answer some questions about your app. Make sure to read them carefully before answering. If your app contains miscellaneous content, it might not get a good rating. Submit the rating and go back to the dashboard. Select your target audience, and make sure to read the instructions before filling out the information. If your app is not a news app and has no relation to COVID-19, select the appropriate options. If your app does not collect or share any user data, select that option. If your app is not a government app, select the appropriate option. Choose the category of your app, in this case, education, and add some relevant tags. Add your email and click Save. You will then need to add short and long descriptions of your app. If you have already written them, you can simply copy and paste them into the appropriate sections. You will also need to add an app icon, a feature graphic, and some screenshots of your app. Make sure to design them according to the required pixels. In the Create and Publish a Release section, you can add the countries where you want to publish your app. If you want to publish it worldwide, select All. Click on Create New Release and upload the AB file. You can also add a message for this release. You might encounter an error when you click on Next. If your app doesn't contain any ads, select No. If it does, select Yes and choose the appropriate options. Save your changes, and the error should disappear. The downloadable size of the application is 10.5 megabytes. Click on Start Rollout to Production, and your app will go through the review process, which can take 2 to 7 days depending on the type of application. That's it for this video. If you're interested in React Native or Firebase, make sure to check out my channel's playlist for more valuable content. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos, and I'll see you in the next one.